Yeah, so today I'm going to talk how to reduce these vibrations. It was actually asked in one of the comments on my previous videos to help, reducing these vibrations. So as you can see here, there are basically three parts in the bike where the vibration actually comes from. So the first one, as you can see here, is right here, is between those gaps. Because these gaps are huge, they tend to vibrate a lot. Same is the here at this side. Also vibrations also come here because there are gaps, so you can see a tape here, and on this side it's pretty much good because there's no gap. Also, the second part where the vibrations come from are the number plates on the front, and the third part is the vibrations coming on the number plate at the back. Okay, so in order to reduce these vibrations, you'll basically need two things. One is a 3M tape, which I'll link below in the description, and you can buy it from there, and a scissor which you'll have at home readily. So what you have to do is take this tape, and depending upon the gap here, you'll have to fold the tape at this length couple of times depending upon your gap. For me it was like three times to get it correctly for this gap. So you take the tape, you fold it three times so that it becomes thick, and you force it into these gaps here. Also, I've done the same. So you basically have to ensure that after you put in these tapes, there are no movements, or the movements are very less, because before putting these tapes in, there were a lot of movements between these joints. Same is the case here, and after putting these, there are no movements. So when even if you start your bike and rev it, there won't be vibrations coming from this part. So, and if there are gaps around here or on the other side, you'll have to remove this thing by removing the Allen screws on both the sides, and you'll have to tape here along the inner side of this part, so that the gap will be reduced and there won't be any vibrations. For me, in this case, this tape was put in by the service center guys when I told them the bike was vibrating a lot. Also, in order to reduce vibrations along the number plate, what you can do is you can put in rubber mounts where both the screws are present between this joint and the number plate, so that it doesn't vibrate. Also, you can put in tapes between these two plates. Okay, as you can see, there are two plates, this first one and the second one, and you can put a tape in between these so they adhere nicely and they won't be vibrating a lot. For me, there were no vibrations coming in from the number plate front and the back as well. Yeah, so this is how you can reduce, and there might be vibrations coming from this part of the bike, but there's nothing much you can do because it is inaccessible. And if you want to further reduce vibrations, you can use Motul oil, because Motul oil does tend out to dampen vibrations and makes the engine a bit more smoother. So as you can clearly hear, there are no vibrations coming from along those parts. Back to the beginning.